Captain Kay dan Matthew ada di Bali Bird Park. Tempat ini terdapat lebih kurang 250 jenis burung yang didatangkan dari Indonesia tentu saja, Amerika Selatan, Australia, dan Afrika. Bahkan di sini banyak sekali burung langka yang dilindungi. Seperti burung rakon yang dipegang Molly ini, teman-teman.
How old is the bird?
This is 6 years old, yeah. Very easy to tell the age of this hornbill. This is we call red hornbill, yeah. You can see the horns on the top of this beak. There are 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 6 years old.
Scars.
Ada bird show tuh. Ini pertunjukan burung liar pemakan daging. Lihat tuh mereka, bahkan terbang dekat sekali dengan penonton. Ini namanya Hercules.
And now I'm one volunteer who wants to be my rabbit. Oh boy?
Okay, come on,
Jason.
Hati-hati, Jason. Jangan bergerak.
Okay, to make more interesting the show. And now let's try without the track.
Apa? Tanpa piring? Oh.
Oh no.
Molly berani enggak ya? Berhasil. Jason dan Molly memang pemberani.
Come on, guys. Let's go and see the other birds.
Okay, sekarang kita lihat Bird Star Show yuk. Kali ini Jason dan Kay yang maju. Gimana rasanya, Jason? Kakak tua hitam terbesar disebut kakak tua raja yang berasal dari Papua. Kakak tua ini bisa hidup sampai 100 tahun loh, teman-teman.
Molly, please come here, yeah? Come on. One, two, and three. Yeah. All right,
ready, guys, yeah? For the next 10 minutes.
You okay? What kind of bird is this?
Black palm cockatoo.
Black palm
cockatoo.
Ada lagi nih kepintaran dari kakak tua ini. Perhatikan deh. Nah, gimana kalau kita kasih makan burung? Ayo, Matthew. Coba lempar yang benar jangkriknya.
What is different from a peacock boy and a peacock girl?
This is the male. The male have long tail. And this is the female. But this one is the moving season of this bird. So the tail is fold down.
It's cool, yeah? And look, I'm gonna throw it up to let the hornbill catch it. Hornbill! Whee! Oh, it didn't catch it.
Right now I'm trying to feed the peacock. And there's worms, peanuts, and corn in here. And the peacock is right over there.
Come on! Cari merak yang kelaparan ya, Jason.
Eating the worms, mostly.
Okay, kita ke tempat lain untuk memberi makan Nuri.
What's his name?
Catherine Roy.
Burung-burung nuri ini makanannya sama kayak bayi ya. Lihat deh, yang di mangkok ini adalah sereal bayi. Nah, kalau ini burung pelikan. Ada yang tahu nggak asalnya burung pelikan? Yep, dari negara tetangga kita, Australia. Hey, jangan terlalu dekat lempar ikannya. Bisa dikejar nanti. Wah, kayaknya mereka masih belum puas nih. Masih mau ngasih makan merpati.
Oh, I'm scared it's gonna go after me.
They're following you.
Disgusting. I think well, inside it has like oranges. Oranges, coconut, jackfruit, papaya, and what is that called?
Guava?
Yeah, whatever. And what is that thing called right there?
Banana?
Yeah.
Molly tahu nggak ya? Penghuni kandang ini siapa aja?
Pigeons and peacock over there. This one. That's also a pigeon. This is a pigeon. I don't know what that is.
There's a lot of birds around us, but they're not coming to eat. But you know what? I know, because we're here. Why don't we go over there and feed some other birds, because I think they want to come and eat.
Let's go, guys. Masih banyak yang bisa kita kunjungi lagi, seperti kakak tua ini.
This is Macaw. This is blue and golden Macaw. All the fish is very tame and friendly. You can hop like this, but not touch.
Why is it eating strawberry?
Oh yeah, this is actually they like chewing something hard. Yeah, like peanuts or the hard peanuts. You know? And these gift stones are just playing for the with this stone.
So how old is it?
This is Rumi. Yeah, his name is Rumi. So Rumi is 8 years old. Okay. Yeah.
Then you're
gonna be
a bit happy. A bit happy, I think.
Male. Order Macaw. Yeah. This is very hard to say which one the male or which one the female. You have to doing DNA test. But this is, I can tell this is male because I know already.
Sepertinya kakak tua ini suka sekali sama Molly. Rambut Molly sampai dia lulus-lulus begitu.
Blooming egg. Blooming egg. Get it off me.
Yeah, are you okay, Molly? Oh, it's getting your extensions.
It feels like someone's pouring like the knife. Someone's poking you in the head. But with the knife this time.
Kalau yang ini namanya rangkong. Oh iya, rangkong berbulu hitam adalah satu-satunya burung yang punya bulu mata. Biarpun terlihat galak, tapi mereka ramah loh. Molly, jangan takut. Yay! Kay hebat. Nggak takut kepiting. Harus hati-hati loh kalau nangkep kepiting. Kayaknya Jason trauma kepiting tuh.
It bit my finger. Well, clawed my finger. There's no cut. There's no cut.
This is the mouth of the crab. This is the claw. This is the eye. And this is the leg.
Right now this crab, I think it's talking to me. Saying, let me go. Are you gonna catch it?
Kepiting yang sedang ditangkap oleh Molly, Jason, Kay, dan Matthew ini hidup di hutan bakau yang letaknya di tepi pantai, teman. Okay, sekarang kepitingnya udah terkumpul banyak. Let's go! Kita sulap jadi yang enak-enak!
Ow! It burnt me! I think you need to do it.
Gini nih teman-teman, cara memanggang kepiting yang gampang. Tusuk kepiting bambu.
The bubbles are coming out.
And there's a lot of bubbles coming out because all of the water inside its stomach.
Oh, look at the color of mine. It looks kind of disgusting.
Hooray! Mateng juga kepitingnya. Selain nggak perlu lama, nggak perlu bumbu juga. Soalnya air laut yang asin sudah membuat kepiting ini berasa.
Now I'm untying the seaweed to the water.
I can feel that they're really bumpy and they're really slimy too. And they taste really salty and seawatery and crunchy.
It's good, I like it.
It's really bad.
Here it goes.
Right now we're gonna dry the seaweed for 2 days.
Daripada kelamaan, mending bikin makanan yuk dari rumput laut.
Right now we're gonna make rujak rumput laut.
hurting my fingers because it's grating against the thing.
Ayo, Kay. Belum pernah parut kelapa, kan? Loh, kok malah dicicipin sih?
Good. Yes. It tastes like... It just tastes nothing.
Nah, setelah itu, cabai digiling sampai halus.
Hard because of the skin and you have to be careful because it might go in your eyes. Now we're gonna put the chili inside the coconut.
Ayo, cicipin rujaknya.
Tastes fishy.
Ew.
And a bit salty.
And it tastes really fishy.
Yakin Matthew suka? Itu kan pedes banget.
Make the soaps.
Jadi ini tempatnya untuk membuat sabun ini?
Ya, betul.
Can I make one to bring home?
Boleh enggak dia bikin beberapa untuk bawa ke rumah?
Boleh, boleh. Mari saya ajarin ya.
Bapaknya baik sekali. Bahan yang harus disiapkan untuk membuat sabun adalah soda api, aroma atau parfum, kunyit, dan alat pencetak sabun.
Pertama-tama kita cairkan dulu soda api.
First, we have to put the baking soda inside there.
Nah, sekarang tinggal tambahkan air untuk melarutkan caustic soda ini.
Then you have to put the water inside the jar so it'll be mixed.
Sekarang saatnya mengaduk.
It's not even hot water here.
The water looks like you know when you take a shower and you put soap on your body and then you wash it off? Looks like that. Why is it hot?
Kenapa ini apa?
Karena campuran air sama caustic soda menimbulkan panas.
Okay. Tanda soda api sudah larut dengan air adalah warna air yang semakin bening. Sekarang kita buat minyak kelapanya ya. Sekarang saatnya memeras kelapa.
It feels kind of good against your skin, but
setelah cukup, air kelapa ini siap untuk dimasak, untuk dijadikan minyak kelapa. Minyak kelapa yang tadi kita buat dicampur dengan campuran soda api dan air. diaduk lagi deh sampai menyatu dan pas juga kental.
Oke, Fanny aduk terus ya sampai kental. Terus Yuan sama Rika bantuin saya numbuk kunyit.
Oke. After this, we have to put this tamarind inside there and crush it.
Kunyit digunakan sebagai rempah campuran untuk sabun. Kunyit berkhasiat membuat kulit lebih halus dan lebih kenyal.
This is harder than the bebek but tutu bumbu.
Yeah, I can tell.
Yeah, it doesn't want to like crush.
Can I try it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hah, iseng banget sih Rika. It's turmeric fight.
Oke, cukup. Sekarang dicampur ke adonan sabunnya.
Okay, after this you have to put this inside there.
Setelah ini kita tambahkan pewangi ke sabun.
Okay, after this we have to put the perfume into the soap.
Okay. Parfumnya 15 ml.
Perfume you have to put 15 milliliters.
The perfume's from France, my country.
Kita tunggu dulu nanti biar jadi. Tunggu keras.
Now we have to leave this under the sun for 1 hour until it could be hard like soap. So
nah, ini sabun yang baru dicetak, belum dipotong-potong. Nah, sekarang kalian boleh motong-motong, terjadiin apa aja terserah kalian.
Asyik! Sambil menunggu sabunnya kering, kita boleh mengukir sabun batangan yang sudah mengering.
Mine's a bit like weird, so I'm gonna like trace the line.
Sudah jadi.
Yes.
Silakan dicopot.
So cool.
It turned out to a soap.
Yeah.
It even smells good too.
Yeah, it does. And like, it's actually like a really good mold of a crab.